to the lesson on solid geometry. In this lesson, we will take a look at 3D figures and how we go about classifying and identifying those figures on their characteristics. Solid geometry is a part of mathematics that deals with three dimensions. Three-dimensional figures are called polyhedrons, which is essentially a three-dimensional shape whose surfaces are polygons. Now, looking at these three shapes, one of them being very recognizable, we would know that the second two are polyhedrons and the first is not, for reasons that we'll discuss in a little bit. Now, polyhedrons have a variety of characteristics that can often be counted and help us identify and describe which ones we're talking about. So when I think about the faces of my polyhedron, I'm thinking about the flat sides. In this case of a cube, we know that our faces are squares. So as I count the faces, I know that this square polyhedron will have 6 faces. I can look at the 4 edges on either side and the 4 edges connecting those 2 sides, giving me a grand total of 12 edges. Vertices, I have 4 on the bottom, 4 on the top, and I have 8 vertices with this polyhedron. Classification-wise, it's important to think about the amount of faces and how they'll give each polyhedron a name. 4 faces will give me tetrahedron, all the way down following the pattern of the prefixes to 12, where I would have dodecahedron extending towards infinity. Now, polyhedrons can come into 2 basic categories, prisms and pyramids. A prism is defined by its 2 congruent bases and a connection of those bases, and the pyramid is defined by its 1 base and its lateral faces all facing towards the apex. Again, with the prism, those polygons are connected by the lateral areas, and with a pyramid, our lateral areas, which are usually triangles, all connect at a top apex. These will be very important characteristics to remember when it comes time to calculating surface area and volume. Now, 3 other types of three-dimensional shapes, which would not be polyhedrons, would be spheres, cylinders, and cones. With a cylinder, we have 2 congruent circular bases and a curved rectangular side. The circular bases is what cancels it out from being a polyhedron. A cone has a circular base and lateral areas that also end at an apex, much like a pyramid. With a sphere, we have a rotated circular space around a given axis. Now, these figures will also have their own formula and their own rules, which is very important to remember as we think that many of our shapes in real life may be a combination of all of those. So now we think about how we would spin a figure. How would we take a two-dimensional shape, spin it around an axis, and then be able to classify the resulting shape? Well, if I draw this semicircle, imagining I continue to draw it around the axis if it were spinning, I would understand that I would get a sphere. I could do the same thing with this triangle, spin it through the axis, and see that I would have a cone. And lastly, with this rectangle spun around its own axis, I would get a cylinder. These problems illustrate the very critical relationship between two-dimensional and three-dimensional shapes.